हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द एसटीएम ट्यूटोरियल्स ऑन एसटीएम 32F103 कंट्रोलर। माय नेम इज अजिंक्य एंड वी आर हियर टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू एसटीएम कंट्रोलर। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस यू हाउ टू इंटरफेस कीज ऑन एसटीएम कंट्रोलर एंड हाउ टू राइट इट्स कोड। वी विल सी द टेस्ट कोड ऑन द सिमुलेशन एट द एंड ऑफ द वीडियो। बिफोर कंटिन्यूइंग टू दिस टॉपिक, हिट सब्सक्राइब इफ यू हैवंट डन इट। सो गाइज, लेट्स गो टू द टॉपिक, द की इंटरफेस। वी ऑफन कम अक्रॉस द सिचुएशन वेर वी वॉन्ट टू ऑटोमेट सम एक्शन डिपेंडिंग ऑन सम एक्सटर्नल इनपुट। द एक्सटर्नल इनपुट कैन बी एनीथिंग फ्रॉम इंटरप्ट और सम इवेंट और सम की इनपुट। वी विल फर्स्ट डिस्कस हाउ की वर्क्स। बेसिकली देर आर अ वैरायटी ऑफ कीज, बट वी विल डिस्कस ओनली टू मेन टाइप्स। फर्स्ट वन इज द लैच की एंड सेकंड वन इज द मोमेंटरी लैच की। वॉट इज द डिफरेंस? द लैच की इज जस्ट लाइक यूर स्विच ऑफ लाइट बल्ब और फैन और एनीथिंग विच कैन बी फाउंड इन यूर हाउस, विच रिमेन्स इन आइदर ऑफ द स्टेट ऑन or off unless you change it. Where is the momentary latch key in your house? You can find it at your doorsteps. Just go on to the front door of your neighbors, hit the doorbell and run as fast as you can. Well, don't do that. I was just kidding. And yes, that is a great example of momentary latch key. Well, you press the bell button, the bell rings, and as soon as you release it, the bell stops. The momentary latch key works in exactly the same way. It retains its state either on or off as long as you press the key. As soon as you release the key, it goes back to its original state. A question may pop up into your storming head. Why are we learning this? Well, there are many uses of both types of keys in electronics. You can make a machine to do certain tasks until you release the stop button, like in music player of your mobile or in a coffee machine, or you just want to do a task only when you press certain key. So the keys are important inputs to the controller. Now we understand why to use key. Let's understand how to use the keys or switches. There are 2 to 3 ways you can use a switch or key. First one is to connect it to the power rail or ground, and whenever you press the key, the power rail or ground rail will be connected to the controller pin. A direct connection is not advisable, so we add some resistance between a key and a pin, or between a power rail, that is VCC or ground, and a switch. Another approach is to use a capacitor with a switch and a resistor. The capacitor takes some time to charge to DC level depending on the series resistor, and it discharges within few microseconds if shorted. So this feature is used in some applications such as reset circuit. Usually a switch is either connected to VCC and a capacitor anode, or directly across the capacitor. I think we had enough talk on why to use and how to use a switch or a key. Let's go to the simulation and coding. First, let's create the circuit diagram in simulation software. I have already built the circuit. This will save our time. You can pause the video to copy the circuit. To set the GPIO functionality, we have to open STM32CubeMX software and set the pin functionalities to GPIO input. To set certain GPIO pin to input function, just click on the pin and select GPIO input. I am showing you for one pin and you have to copy for the rest. Now we have set all the GPIO inputs. Set the project name as key input. Set the directory where you want to save your code. Let's generate the code by selecting MDK ARM IDE in toolchain option and click on generate code. The STM32CubeMX will generate code for our editing. Open Keel IDE by clicking on open project. Click on application/users. Click on mail.c. Now go to while loop. Let's write our code here. Now suppose you want to blink red LED on switch 1 and make yellow LED on or off on the switch 2, which is a latch switch. We will require both read and write functions of GPIO. First, copy the write functions and paste it for pin 3 and pin 4. We have connected the red LED to pin 3 and yellow LED to pin 4. So we'll first write to blink red LED. Write GPIO 3 to reset. Give some delay. Write GPIO 3 to set and give some delay. This will blink the red LED. Now write GPIO 4, set variable. GPIO 4 will be set as per the set var status, either set or reset state. Now copy the read function from GPIO init function. Paste it in while loop. So we want to blink the red LED when switch 1 is pressed. This will make the pin LED tied to logic 1. GPIO 4 will be set as per the set fire status, either set or reset state. Now copy the read function from GPIO init function. Paste it in while loop. So we want to blink LED when switch 1 is pressed. This will make the pin tied to logic 1 or logic high. So we will write the condition as when GPIO 1 status is high, blink the LED, and when it is low, make the LED off. Now for the latch switch, when switch 2 is pressed and GPIO is high, let's make the yellow LED glow, and when switch 2 is released or made off, the LED will be off. Simple. I have written the code in advance, I'll explain it to you. Here first if condition. When switch status is high, blink the LED. When switch status is low, make the LED off. When switch 2 status is high, glow yellow LED, else turn off the yellow LED. Now that all is set, let's build the code. It will generate the hex file into project directory. Let's go to the simulation. Double click on the controller, go to the directory where you saved the code, select the hex file and click on open. Make sure you have set the power rails for the controller. If not, just go to the previous videos and check how to set the power rails in simulation software. Click on run button. Click on the switches. Try changing their status and observe the LED. And if you enjoy the video, click on like, share and subscribe.